I bumped my head a few times. I had some head trauma and shit, you know? So I can't rightly recall exactly, but if my memory still serves me correctly, I'm wanting to say this is some of that good old Pray for the Devil, Devil James Workshop cult film shit. Baby doll, if you know what I mean. Or, I meant to say. I bumped my head a few times. I had some head trauma and shit, you know? So I can't rightly recall exactly, but if my memory still serves me correctly, I'm wanting to say this is some of that good old Pray for the Devil, Devil James Workshop cult film shit. Baby doll, if you know what I mean. Or, I meant to say.
Metamorphosis, the Alien Factor. A new chapter in terror is about to unfold.
This is the house where evil dwells. An evil both ancient and inexorable. Malicious and merciless. I know. I was there. My name is Damon Bund, and I am a demon hunter.
This way, this way. Wait, I hear something. Wait, there's something back there. What? There's something. Good God, what is that? Jesus Christ, get me out of here!
God himself has charged me to protect his children against the evil that walks among us. The evil that corrupts the innocent and consumes the soul. Lust and carnal desire are his weapons. Fear is his seduction. Human arrogance and folly opened the doorway. And hell was loosed upon the earth. So join me, Damon Bund, as I battle the demons that plague our world. And devour our souls. Experience the fear for yourself. Experience the terror of Hellhounds.
Hellhounds, a comedy of terrors. Evil is coming.
It's the power. Holy bullshit. It's the power of Christ that compels you.
Guilty before the whole human race. It's the Lord who expects you. He who is coming to judge both the living and the dead and the world by fire.
Yeah!
Lonely is the night.
hurt your own. Lonely is the night when there's no one left to call. You feel the time is right. Say the writing's on the wall. Yeah.
Don't tell me how to raise my family. I told you not to tell me how to raise my family.
Daniel.
So what do you see?
Hellhounds.
You look like a fool, don't you, Dilfin?
I'm controlled by them.
I'm controlled by them.
I anoint you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Look at me. So I write this curse.
I break this curse!
Of Jezebel.
These people have real feelings of inferiority. So what you're seeing when you're dealing with a narcissist in general is a false sense of superiority. Somebody that's really powerful, somebody that's really smart, somebody that's really skilled, really good at something, they don't need to tell you all the time how smart and good they are.
Jezebel, I'm going to take the sword of the spirit and put it right through your back. What is your name in Persian?
The man is on the prowl. Get the dynamite. The boys are set to prowl. Lonely is the night when you hear the voices call. Are you ready for a fight? Do you wanna take it all?
When I say these people are grandiose, they just think they are something special. Better than you, above you. They come across that way. And they have this insatiable need for admiration. They've got to be the center of attention. Everybody has to think they're special. They need for you to admire them and hold them up on a pedestal. And because they have to be the focus of attention and admiration at all times, then their relationships are superficial.
Lonely is the night when you find yourself alone. Your demons come to life. And your mind is not your own. Lonely is the night when there's no one left to call. You feel the time is right. Say the writing's on the wall. Yeah.
Well, I love arena. I love arena. I love to hear the thunder. Watch the lightning when it lights up the sky.
A trigger is an emotional activation. Often, it's the result of unmet needs, emotional wounds, past events, some of them traumatic, that we carry with us. And then we use those events, those experiences, to assign a meaning to things that are happening in our current environment.
Well, I love a rainy night, such a beautiful sight. I love to feel rain on my face, taste the rain on my lips.
Following up with a video about the isolation period of healing. Some of you might know this or have heard it referenced as the dark night of the soul.
'Cause I love a rainy night. Yeah, I love a rainy night.
Fuck your goopy commie bullshit. You don't get to fucking tell me how to raise my dogs.
Sir Lord Devil James reminds all you commie cocksucker haters that you do not get to fucking tell him how to raise his dogs.
I told you not to tell me how to raise my family.
It's a hard time to fight when the walls are closing in. Call it what you like. It's time you got to win. Lonely, lonely, lonely. Your spirit's sinking down.
Don't tell me how to raise my family. I told you not to tell me how to raise my family.
Daniel.
So what do you see?
Hellhounds.
You look like a fool, don't you, Dilford?
I'm controlled by them. I'm controlled by them. I know it's your name, but the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. So I break this curse. I break this curse. So I break this curse.
I break this curse.
Of Jezebel.
Jezebel.
These people have real feelings of inferiority. So what you're seeing when you're dealing with a narcissist in general is a false sense of superiority.
Holy mother. It's the power of Christ that compels you.
Guilty before the whole human race. It's the Lord who expects you. He who is coming to judge both the living and the dead and the world by fire.
These people have real feelings of inferiority. So what you're seeing when you're dealing with a narcissist in general is a false sense of superiority. Somebody that's really powerful, somebody that's really smart, somebody that's really skilled, really good at something, they don't need to tell you all the time how smart and good they are.
Jezebel, I'm going to take the sword of the spirit and put it right through your back.
When you find yourself alone, your demons come to light, and your mind is not your own. Lonely is the night, when there's no one left to call. You feel the time is right, say the writing's on the wall.
I don't want to just read a list off to you, I want to talk about it so it means something to you. When I say these people are grandiose, they just think they are something special. Better than you. Above you. They come across that way. And they have this insatiable need for admiration. They've got to be the center of attention. Everybody has to think they're special. They need for you to admire them and hold them up on a pedestal. And because they have to be the focus of attention and admiration at all times, then their relationships are superficial, because in order for a relationship to be healthy, it has to be give and take. One way to control a relationship is to be constantly the giver, constantly the power figure. It takes vulnerability to receive. It takes vulnerability to say you need something from someone. And a narcissist doesn't need anything from anybody, because they're godlike. They are a power figure. So they have this superficial, exploitive string of relationships where they never get really close to anybody. And one thing they do not have is empathy.
What started this curse? Older
Well, I love a rainy night, I love a rainy night. I love to hear the thunder, watch the lightning when it lights up the sky.
A trigger is an emotional activation. Often, it's the result of unmet needs, emotional wounds, past events, some of them traumatic, that we carry with us. And then we use those events, those experiences, to assign a meaning to things that are happening in our current environment.
Well, I love a rainy night. Such a beautiful sight. I love to feel rain on my face.
Lonely is the night on my lid. When you find yourself alone, your demons come to light, and your mind is not your own. Lonely is the night when there's no one left to call. You feel the time is right. Say the writing's on the wall. Yeah.
Following up with the video about the isolation period of healing. Some of you might know this or have heard it referenced as the dark night of the soul.
Cause I love a rainy night. Yeah, I love a rainy night.
Fuck your goofy commie bullshit. You don't get to fucking tell me how to raise my dogs.
Sir Lord Devil James reminds all you commie cocksucker haters that you do not get to fucking tell him how to raise his dogs.
Yeah, I'll take a river down to Stillwater and ride a pack of dogs.
Hellish-Hounds, a comedy of terrors. Evil is coming.
Don't tell me how to raise my family. I told you not to tell me how to raise my family.
Daniel.
So what do you see?
Hellhounds.
You look like a fool, don't you, Dilfer?
I'm controlled by them. I'm controlled by them.
I anoint you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Look at me.
I told you not to tell me how to raise my family.
It's a hard time to fight when the walls are closing in. Call it what you like. It's time you got to win. Lonely, lonely, lonely. Your spirit's sinking down. You find you're not the only stranger in this town.
Fuck your goofy commie bullshit. You don't get to fucking tell me how to raise my dogs.
Sir Lord Devil James reminds all you commie cocksucker haters that you do not get to fucking tell him how to raise his dogs.
Don't tell me how to raise my family. I told you not to tell me how to raise my family.
Daniel.
So what do you see? You look like a fool, don't you, Dilfer?
Yeah, I'll take a river down to Stillwater and ride a pack of dogs.
Hellhounds, a comedy of terrors. Evil is coming.
I'm controlled by them. I'm controlled by them.
I anoint you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Look at me.
It's the power of Christ that compels you.
Guilty before the whole human race. It's the Lord who expects you. He who is coming to judge both the living and the dead, and the world by fire.
I'm controlled by them.
I'm controlled by them.
I anoint you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Look at me. So I write this curse.
I break this curse!
So I break this curse.
I break this curse!
Of Jezebel.
Jezebel.
When there's no one left to call.
These people have real feelings of inferiority. So what you're seeing when you're dealing with a narcissist in general is a false sense of superiority. Somebody that's really powerful, somebody that's really smart, somebody that's really skilled, really good at something, they don't need to tell you all the time how smart and good they are.
Jezebel, I'm going to take the sword of the spirit and put it right through your back. What is your name in Persian?
I don't want to just read a list off to you. I want to talk about it so it means something to you. When I say these people are grandiose, they just think they are something special. They're better than you, above you. They come across that way. And they have this insatiable need for admiration. They've got to be the center of attention. Everybody has to think they're special. They need for you to admire them and hold them up on a pedestal. And because they have to be the focus of attention and admiration at all times, then their relationships are superficial, because in order for a relationship to be healthy, it has to be give and take. One way to control a relationship is to be constantly the giver, constantly the power figure.
Well, I love a rainy night, I love a rainy night. I love to hear the thunder, watch the lightning when it lights up the sky.
A trigger is an emotional activation. Often, it's the result of unmet needs, emotional wounds, past events, some of them traumatic, that we carry with us. And then we use those events, those experiences, to assign a meaning to things that are happening in our current environment.
Well, I love a rainy night. Such a beautiful sight. I love to feel rain on my face.
Lonely is the night when you find yourself alone. Your demons come to light and your mind is not your own. Lonely is the night when there's no one left to call. You feel the time is right. Say the writing's on the wall. Yeah.
Following up with a video about the isolation period of healing. Some of you might know this or have heard it referenced as the dark night of the soul.
Fuck your goofy commie bullshit. You don't get to fucking tell me how to raise my dogs.
Sir Lord Devil James reminds all you commie cocksucker haters that you do not get to fucking tell him how to raise his dogs.
Don't tell me how to raise my family. I told you not to tell me how to raise my family.
Daniel.
So what do you see?